In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use Blender's cloth pin feature. Let's create a curve rectangle. If you don't see that in the menu, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. In edit mode, type V as in Victor and A. Right-click and type S to subdivide. I'll shift select 4 curve points like this, and type S to scale. Let's turn this 2D curve into 3D, and set its fill mode to full. Now we can bevel the curve. Right-click to convert to mesh. In edit mode, let's press Shift, Z to wireframe view, and type C to circle select the faces like this. Please remember to type 3 to face select. Shift, D to duplicate, Enter to settle, and P to separate. Since the mesh's origin is at the world center location, we can duplicate the separated mesh and rotate it 90 degrees. But we need to have a fabric mesh connected to the separated meshes first. We'll be using Blender's Bridge Edge Loop feature, and in order to use that, we need to extend an edge in the middle first. In edit mode, type 2 to edge select. Click this edge, and Ctrl-click the last edge. E to extrude. Let's duplicate and rotate the mesh 90 degrees 3 times. Shift select the meshes and Ctrl J to join them together. Let's create a plane and scale it down. We need to have a matching number of faces before bridge edge loop them. In edit mode, I right-clicked and typed S to subdivide it 7 times. In object mode, let's join the two meshes. In edit mode, Ctrl-click the edges like this, and Shift-Ctrl-click the edges to be bridge edge looped. I right-clicked and selected Bridge Edge Loop to connect them. This is how the mesh was designed. From here, I'll show you how the mesh's cloth pin was arranged. In wireframe view, I have selected the outer vertices that is wrapping around the pipe mesh, and pressed Ctrl, G, to vertex group them. They're being used as the cloth pin vertices, in order to prevent them from reacting like fabric surfaces. The rest of the mesh was invert selected, and subdivided. Ctrl, I, as in India to invert the selection. I have used cloth and rigid body physics. Only the cloth physics can be used, but the rigid body will create a harsh drop motion. The frame mesh has a collision physics. I'll show you where we pin the vertices. It's located under Shape and Pin Group. We can pin any vertices, and the pinned vertices will act as an immovable anchor for the cloth physics vertices. I'll show you the material details as well. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.